Hello and welcome to the agenda. I am Ajay Kaul. Today we will discuss about Pakistan's complicity with terrorism. A Pakistani court has ordered immediate release of four terrorists who had been found guilty by it in 2002 of kidnapping and murdering American journalist Daniel Pearl. The four terrorists include Ahmed Omar Syed Sheikh, who was released by India in 1999 in exchange of the passengers of hijacked Indian Airlines plane. So what does it tell us about Pakistan and its institutions? We will analyze this in the agenda today with two defense experts. We have with us Mr. Jitendra Kumar Oja, who is an expert on geopolitical matters, and retired Brigadier Vinod Datta. But before we begin our conversation, let's have a look at this small report.
18 years back, Ahmed Omar Syed Sheikh and three other terrorists were convicted for kidnapping and murdering American journalist Daniel Pearl by the Sindh High Court in Pakistan and given death sentence. Now the same High Court has ordered his immediate release, saying the detention was illegal. Early in April, the court had converted their death sentence to 7-year detention. They were kept in jail and the temporary detention order since then. Pearl was the South Asia bureau chief of Wall Street Journal and was kidnapped and beheaded by terrorists when he was in Karachi to report on Pakistani extremists and British shoe bomber Richard Reid and complicity of terrorists with Pakistan's intelligence agency ISI. Significantly, Syed Sheikh carried out the kidnapping and killing of Pearl almost 3 years after he was released by Indian exchange of passengers on board hijacked Air India plane IC-814 in December 1999. The aircraft was hijacked during its flight from Kathmandu to Delhi on December 24 and was commandeered to Kandahar in Afghanistan, which was then being ruled by the Taliban. The hijackers had demanded release of Syed Sheikh along with Masood Azhar and Mushtaq Zargar. Sheikh was in Indian prison for terrorist activities. Azhar, who was then associated with Harkat-ul-Jihad-e-Islam, floated Jaish-e-Mohammed within months of his release on December 31, 1999. The US, which has been stunned by the Pakistani court verdict, has expressed deep concern over it and hoped that Syed Sheikh's release would be challenged in higher court. But the Pakistani court verdict leads to a question: are all institutions of Pakistan favoring terrorism? Bureau report.
Now let's welcome our guests, Mr. Oja and Mr. Brigadier Datta. Welcome to the program, both of you, sir.
Thank you.
Let me begin by asking, referring Mr. Oja to the latest verdict by Sindh High Court in Pakistan about releasing Daniel Pearl's murderer, Ahmed Omar Sheikh. How do you see, what does it tell us about Pakistan's institutions?
Firstly, there is no autonomy of judiciary in Pakistan. Whatever military establishment decides and dictates, judiciary has to follow it. Under some international pressure, certainly they awarded punishment to these people. They were sent to jail. But this clearly says that Pakistani military establishment is very important, very confident. And the moment they have issued this instruction, judiciary has complied with this. And this is also a signal to the West, because, you know, America needs Pakistan very much for its extrication from Afghanistan. And that security establishment has depended entirely on Pakistani military establishment to have a deal with Taliban. And now, maybe Pakistan is seeking to exploit it. Despite international pressure through FATF and other instruments, Pakistan has managed to evade that pressure. So I think this is an extremely worrying sign and we have to take serious note of it.
No, it's not worrying sign for only us. It is a worrying sign for the Americans. Pakistan is showing thumb to Americans also. Although American State Department has said that we are concerned, but it means nothing. What do you say?
No, I would tell that, you know, in America, this is another warning for the entire world and free societies, because their security establishment has not appeared very cohesive. You see, Osama bin Laden was caught in Abbottabad. Still nothing happened. Right. Because some sections within their security establishment, they continue to believe that Pakistan is needed by them for their counter-terror operations or larger design, or maybe as a strategic partner or some kind of thing is there. because despite all this, it has not happened. Pakistan has also succeeded in negotiating some amount of loan. So I'm not trying to say that entire American establishment is favoring Pakistan, but Pakistan certainly has very strong quarters of support in America, and America, that you know, terrorism in South Asia is does not constitute their core security interest. Maybe certain sections believe it. I think there's need for greater clarity and cohesion on part of American security establishment, is what I would say, Ajay. And we have to push or nudge Americans in that direction.
Right. So, Brigadier Datta, so when it comes to Pakistan's complicity with terrorism, it is not only India which it, I mean, it doesn't act on. It's Americans also, they are showing thumb. What do you say?
Yeah, I agree with you, Kaul Saab. This release is a a clear indication of Pakistan showing thumb to the entire world community that we are going to remain the way we want, and you know, nothing is going to deter us. And the world community, and especially the UN General Assembly, should take a cognizance of it, because this is not time Pakistan has shown audacity as far as these acts are concerned. If you go back, you will realize that ISI was giving Masood Azhar a very handsome amount, which was to the tune of $60,000 for his operations and maintenance. Pakistan has not been able to justify the existence of three people. One is Lakhvi, the other is Masood Azhar, and Dawood Ibrahim. And now David Pearl, who has been established as an offender, who's been declared as a terrorist.
Not Pearl. Ahmed Umar Sheikh.
Pearl was slaughtered.
Pearl was killed. Yeah. Sorry, correction. Yeah. So, you know, Pakistan has to now take very stern actions. And the world community should take a note of it. FATF review is due in February. So, various countries who are there, they should take cognizance of it. And Pakistan should be totally, outcast as far as terrorism is concerned, because they are not only supporting it, they are overtly, helping these organizations.
They are brazen about it. And I may point out here, when we talk about brazenness and audacity of Pakistan, so if we take the case of Ahmed Umar Sheikh, he was the one of the three terrorists who was released by India in exchange of the hijacked, passengers of the hijacked plane in 1999, yeah. December. So it is clear that he was a terrorist. Pakistan knows it. So when it comes to acting, so what more proof do they want?
Exactly, Kaul Saab, you see, we have endorsed so many dossiers. We have given n number of evidence to Pakistan and to the world community. But Pakistan cares for this, and they keep on, throwing some spanner or the other in the proceedings. And now it is high time that India should take action, or they should take punitive action. And, the kind of euphoria or the kind of fear which Pakistan is reeling these days, and we must convert them into actions. Because if you see America, whether it was, operations in Abbottabad, or it was like America's operation in Barishta, Kunitara, the American government has taken actions. Like what we did in a surgical strike in Balakot.
Right.
So without delaying our actions, or without, creating a rhetoric on it, we must convert our actions into destroying these camps and, neutralizing these terrorists. Because Pakistan, it is confirmed, is not going to take any action.
Right.
And America these days is in such a limbo because of the change of power. There was a very beautiful article these days that the President Trump is totally absolved himself, not taking interest whether it is a COVID or this thing. He has been seen golfing on weekends and all. Of course, right. There's nothing wrong with the golfing, but yes, this transition period is very, very crucial, and Pakistan is going to take benefit of this.
Right. So, Mr. Oja, as Brigitte Datta mentioned about dossiers. India has given dossiers after dossiers to Pakistan about terrorists. But particularly in the case of Ahmed Omar Sheikh, I don't think there need to be any dossier, because it is well known that he was the one of the terrorists which the hijackers wanted. And he was released in Kandahar and he went to Pakistan and he was openly moving in Pakistan. So there is no dossier. It's everything is open. So then why Pakistan should not act?
I think we have to change our approach. And I feel that counter-terror strategy should be part of a broader national security strategy, which we have been very reluctant to undertake. Look, dossier, etc. may be required. I'm not saying we should dispense with dossier. And diplomatic pressure engagements are needed. But we have to be very clear in our mind that this is a war. And the Pakistani establishment is not going to give up war. I have always considered terrorism and insurgency both, you know, as instruments of irregular warfare. And apart from this comes propaganda. So entire Pakistani military establishment survives domestically within Pakistan by winning this kind of covert war. And I've mentioned even on your show that this kind of covert war has a lot of other gains for them. One gain is, of course, financial. Other gain is, of course, political clout internationally. So if you do expect that Pakistani establishment is going to give it up so easily, I don't think this is going to be possible. And I also don't think that, you know, surgical strike alone will be able to deter this massive, I would say, infrastructure for terror they have managed to get. This can be one of the multiple steps, but I think we have to pick up this problem at various levels for Americans and others. This may be of peripheral interest,
so,
of course, when
so
9/11
Mr. Oja,
happened, it was
so
of
Mr. Oja, Mr. Oja,
nature.
Yeah.
They have managed to secure their own area. We have to have a much stronger national security strategy, and part of it should be this counter-terror strategy. And we should not expect that by giving those years, by international opinion, by this pressure, Pakistan will mind its business. Sorry, that is not going to happen.
So, Mr. Oja, as you said that surgical strikes won't help. So, what else? What are the options then?
No. I am saying surgical strikes alone won't help.
Are not enough. Okay.
Yeah, not sufficient.
Yeah.
It's not sufficient.
So, what are the other options?
Strikes has.
What are the other options?
Look, we have to have a very clear strategy. What we expect, as I said, in Pakistan, if we have to do everything possible to bring some kind of democratization in Pakistan, bring some kind of thing, not on our own, but in collaboration with international community. They have managed to hoodwink the national security, there is no doubt about it. And there has to be some kind of engagement. I say in this kind of war, you have to have both defensive and offensive capacity. Defensive capacity would be what?
Strong and firm criminal justice system, which does not allow any space for Pakistan to create problems within our own country. That is one area. And right from their defense procurement to capacity to everything, that should have been taken care of. What a disgrace it is that we had to hand over terrorists in 1999, and 21 years we have not done enough. No, we need to do far more than this. And this
has to be multiple pressure through every possible means. And this would not be sufficient by speaking on television debates. This requires stronger, not only diplomatic capacity, but even our private sector, our media, you know, all this, like our R&D, every institution has to come to a different level. Counter-terror should not be our sole object. Our entire national security capacity should be such that with
some investment of time and energy, we should be able to sort out this problem. But you know, our entire psyche has remained inward-looking. We are far too involved and far too engaged in addressing domestic issues. We cannot copy America. When I said surgical strike, America has a different requirement, different approach, different level, and different kind of thing. We have to have our own strategy, and our own strategy means a very strong national cohesion, not through Chinese and other means, but our own means. There has to be, you know, a complete restructuring of our institutions in such a manner that we remain in domestically cohesive, and then we have a very clear agenda in Pakistan. Sorry, not only destruction of terror camps, destruction of very ecosystem in which these things flourish, because
right.
They are still thinking that they are fighting a civilizational war with India, like Mahmood Ghazni, with smaller number of people who was able to overpower a much larger power. Our defense forces have been teaching them befitting lessons. Do you think any justification that 93,000 prisoners of war in 71, we just gave them away and we got nothing in return?
Right.
In 65, you know, our defense forces secured such spectacular victory, secured territory, we gave them away. We have to change our entire approach, Kalsap, and we have to have, as I said, a very integrated strategy and a firm timeline in 5 years, 10 years. This menace called Pakistani terrorism should be buried. It is very easy to say, very difficult, And I think, you know, a major change in our psyche and thought process is required. And from there would flow restructuring of all these institutions and not merely dossier and diplomacy and begging to international community. Sorry, a major country like us, a big country like us, with this kind of history, we don't deserve this humiliation.
Right. Brigadier Datta, you heard Mr. Oja that he wants and he is favoring a revamp of the whole strategy. So what do you say?
You see, I agree with him partially, but I would like to take the discussion further.
Yeah.
What he says is, yes, there is a need that we have to have a relook on our actions now. Dialogues, diplomacy have not yielded the desired results. So what is required is, today we have this kind of technology. It is not that... you know, if India takes any kind of punitive strikes, today you have that kind of technology where you can engage the pinpoint targets. The accuracy is almost, 100% these days.
But that technology has to be used.
Yeah, that technology has to be used.
When?
Because, you see, yeah.
What is the threshold?
Yeah, the threshold, you see, we have already reached the threshold. We have more than 1 lakh people who have lost life, both in uniform and civilians. The Kashmir is reeling under so much of, bloodshed. People have been, development has been stalled. Corruption is there. So this is high time. It is also the duty of the government to realize that, yes, this is the opportune time when we can strike. And the moment, you see, it is not an aggression on a nation. It is an aggression towards terrorism.
Right.
And which is condemned by every state, every individual, every citizen. Pakistan is not affected.
Suppose we were to target Masood Azhar.
Yeah.
So why are
Masood
we not...
Azhar,
He's a declared proclaimed terrorist by UN. So what stops us from targeting him?
Yeah, yes, we can do that. You see, today you have technology like what was done to General Qasim.
That's what I'm saying.
He was converted into pieces. Today you know that his office is in Markaz Subhanallah, where he's training 600 cadres. So you can keep a movement on his moves. And he can be punished for the acts which he has done.
Right.
And you can start simultaneously engaging, right from Murid ke, you have camps in Rawalpindi, Manshera, whatever, Kotli, whichever launch pads are there, they can addressed.
I have always believed. You can shift one launch pad to another. But I'll come back to you, but I think Mr. Oja wants to say something. You can shift one launch pad. You can target one launch pad, it will be shifted to another. That doesn't serve any purpose. Targeting the head is important. Mr. Oja.
No, yes, I agree that, we have to target these people. But this itself is not going to be sufficient, Ajayji. This has to be. I'm not discounting this process. But look at the United States. $10 trillion, they are poorer. They have lost their global preeminence. In many areas, Chinese have advanced toward them. But still, they have not been able to eliminate this curse of terrorism. So what I'm not saying that this should not be there. This has to be there. What I'm saying, whatever strategy we are adopting, this has to be cost effective. This can dislocate, targeting 1, 2, 3, 4 top leadership there can dislocate. But there is a larger ecosystem. If one is dislocated, second one comes. Second one is killed, third one comes. I have maintained on your program that without global organized crime, $800 billion of this thing is being generated and large part of it can be easily deployed. Without telling this kind of propaganda where people are just willing to die, I think all this ecosystem has to be taken care of and India cannot do it on its own. We are lucky that we enjoy goodwill of most of the countries within West Asia, within Africa, as well as West Asia, and even in the West. But, speaking is not going to be sufficient. As I have said, that we have to show our resolve first by restructuring our domestic institutions, being very firm and tight. If money laundering can go on in your country, how can you talk about, that we are sincere about terrorism? When this kind of negative propaganda goes on, there are people who are saying all kinds of things against Hinduism and Hindu this thing, and still we are being targeted by the West for nothing. Many cases, what they're doing by social media for against all Muslims, this is also a very bad thing. We cannot vote it. So, when we are not able to, we will not be able to convince even West. And secondly, as I said, lot of this cannot be discussed on television. I have to be circumspect.
Right, right.
I think if government of the day is sincere, get right, not just in 10 years' time, 12 years' time, 15 years' time, we can sort out this problem and bring it to a level. World will not be perfect.
Right.
Bring it to a level from where red from the sun will be permanently eradicated. And mind it, as the people said, I'm carrying it forward. Good people in Pakistan, civilized people in Pakistan, normal people in Pakistan, they will look up to us, even now they look up to us. They are not going to be threatened. This is going to provide security.
Okay, Mr. Ojha. We are running out of time. Brigadier Datta, last question to you. As Mr. Ojha is saying, that we have goodwill and we should use that and maybe use this goodwill and maybe hit. What do you say? Last comments.
Yes, that's a good point. But we have tried all these options, but they have not given the desired results. And it is high time that, yes, there are instances, at international level where the terrorist organizations have been punished. You take the case of Israel, you take the case of America. So nothing is stopping India to, pinpoint such targets and keep these terrorists on move. You see, this operation All Out in Kashmir Valley, you see, it has really given very good results.
Right.
And today, all these tanzeems are running helter-skelter. So we must keep that option of aggressiveness open,
right.
And it should keep Pakistan guessing that when is it going to come.
Right, very true. So we had to.
I'll just say one sentence.
Yeah, please.
Ajay ji, I'll say just one sentence.
Yeah.
Of course we have to do it, and we have to go far beyond that. Not only we have to keep them on run, but we also have to keep Pakistan establishment on run. We have to facilitate that anyone who attempts and thinks on these lines. 100 times and that person is deterred. So I'm 100% with Brigadier, but I'm saying we have to go way beyond that. And second, I'm saying the cost has to be calculated. If a country like United States of America, after investing $10 trillion, has not been able to eradicate, we have to think beyond that. We have to be far more innovative.
Right.
I'm not denying this has to be part, but
right,
it is
right.
Part of a much bigger strategy.
So we need to have a relook at the re-strategy and maybe do it better way how to target this terror camp, terror heads in Pakistan. But thank you both of you for participating in this debate today.
Thank you.
This is all in the agenda today. Thanks for watching. I'll be back with another important topic tomorrow. Till then, goodbye.